Wow, 3 days of lockdown, locked inside with arms folded, waiting. No presentations or probably travel. You don't have to wake up, leave the kids at school, or probably you have to do the shopping and the marketing and take the, you know, friends and family to PVR. No partying, not opening bottles, no shouting out loud, no dancing around, but at home, at peace.
But why not dancing around?
Yeah, no, outside dancing around. So, ladies and gentlemen, outside I cannot stop yeah. myself to introduce you to India's first sales and profit engineer itself. It's a new word for me as well. And put your hands together for the man in person. And I'm so happy and so glad that, sir, you could actually give your valuable time and you took this interview as a challenge. And I'm so happy that this is something which is going to be the next level of the kind of interviews that I'm doing. So, ladies and gentlemen, once again, with warm wishes and folded arms, let me welcome Mr. Yathiraj. Thank you so much for your time, Chief.
Thank you, Amit. Thank you so much. And, you know, just to start off, okay, right now we are doing this call itself is a challenge because this is the first time ever that I'm doing a kind of a Zoom call on mobile. I have done a lot of Zoom call. Okay, people call me a Zoom expert kind of thing because I have a 1 year program, which is called 3x your profit in 1 year. We have a full day session and every 2 weeks, and it's entirely on Zoom.
Right.
So this is the first time I'm doing it on a cell phone, right? No power. Yeah, there is no power, no net, no internet. Right now I'm using, the mobile data. Yeah.
Nice. And I think, you know, this is the next level of, the structures. So ladies and gentlemen, if you're working here, so there are two Zoombies. I think that's a new word. Zoombies here, which is going to be something which will be a great time. So I'm sure you can take your pen and paper wherever you are. And there are a lot of bullets coming, shotting to you because I know Mr. Yathiraj, once he starts his roller coaster AK-47, you're going to get all the wisdom words straight to you. So let's start with this. Why don't we have a kind of a small introduction, Yattiji, and why don't you tell about how you all started and what you do? There are a lot of people who might be knowing you for the first time. I have got a lot of international friends who are also watching this. So over to you, Chief. How do you want to introduce yourself? I leave it to you.
Okay. I come from a lower middle class family. Okay, so when I was a child, we had food. We had nothing more than food. We didn't even have a bicycle. And that is the situation in which I was, you know, born and brought up. I was very good in studies. So finally, I got into BITS Pilani. Mm-hmm. And I was excited. But then again, I don't want to go into the story. But after that, I got a very good job in one of the best companies in the world called Research and Hindustan that time, Procter & Gamble now. Mm-hmm. And I left the job after 5 years because I wanted to start my own business. Mm-hmm. And looking back, it was a great decision, but at that time it was a bad decision because mm-hmm. I came to the footpath. I did not even have three meals a day till 1989. Mm-hmm. And in 1990, I was on my first flight to US.
Oh, awesome.
Within 1 year. Okay, not even having three meals a day to a flight to Disney World was a big achievement. So when I look back, what made the difference is, of course, sales. I have been in sales all my life and I love selling. And but you know what I understood in that 1 year was it was the sales training. Mm-hmm. Until that time, I was not trained. I was just doing selling and I thought I was a good salesperson. But that is the time I realized I was not and I got a sales training. So right. Now, you know, today when I look around, I find the biggest challenge in most of the businesses is sales.
Right. So I would also like to probably, you know, take this sales thing because some or the other way, you know, when you ask a kid, what do you want to grow up as? And the usual answer is like doctor, engineer, some sort of, you know, a government employee or getting into army, you know, flying the pilot as a jet, all these things. But technically no one says, I want to grow up as a salesman. So what is your take on that particular English word? Over to you.
You are absolutely right. And the major reason for that is because most of the people, in fact, I would say 90, maybe 95, 98, 99, I don't know the exact number, but 90, I would say 99% of the people don't even understand the word sales. Mm-hmm. Okay, they only think of sales as somebody who is trying to push somebody something to you. Whereas if you go into my dictionary, sales is the most noble profession in the world. I repeat that. Sales is the most noble profession in the world. Ask me why. Because a doctor gets paid whether the patient survives or dies. A teacher gets paid whether the student passes or fails. But a salesperson gets paid if and only if he is able to solve his customer's problem.
Absolutely fine. And I would also take your directions, of guidance towards sales and serving. If you can just put some thought on that.
Okay. First of all, let me give you my definition of selling.
Please go ahead.
Okay. My definition of selling is solving people's problems at a profit. Mm-hmm. I'll repeat that. Selling is solving people's problems at a profit.
Right.
So if you are not solving people's problems, you are not in selling.
Right.
You are only in conning people.
Nice.
Okay. So selling has two parts. Number one, solving people's problem. Number two, a profit. So unless both of these are there, it is not selling. So we have to start with solving people's problems. And again, if you are not making a profit, then you are not in self, you are in social service. Is there anything wrong with social service? No, nothing with social service. It's great, but that is not selling. So selling means you must be able to make profit, but more than making profit, you must be able to solve people's problems.
Right.
So once you understand this definition, once you buy into this definition, you will be able to understand why selling is the most noble profession.
Yeah.
Am I making any sense?
Yeah. Please go ahead. And the question was selling and serving.
Yes. So if you are solving people's problem, you're serving, because everybody in the world has a problem. Mm. Okay. You hardly find anybody in the world who doesn't have a problem. And most of the time we don't have a solution. So for example, right now, as I'm talking to you right now, okay, I have this internet problem. I have this broadband problem.
Right.
Okay. So if somebody can come and solve this problem for me, they should be able to make a profit. But so, unfortunately, today.
Right. Can I tell you something about, something that is right now going on my mind is, I am probably, on a different mission right now. I am actually helping people who have some sort of an idea, some sort of a willpower, some sort of, commitment and a passion around, and putting a kind of an entire enterprise with a new dimension to it. So I basically generate entrepreneurs. And as you were telling this, the idea which is popping up, if audience were listening to this, this can be a good short-term income for you. There are a lot of people who are stuck at home. There are a lot of people who needs those kind of an ideation, might be their internet is not working, but they are on phone. If you can help them on phone and guide them, probably you can exchange a small part, might be 10 bucks or 20 bucks, and help them how to solve the existing internet issues or electrical issues. Do it by yourself on the phone call service. Just imagine how big that industry is. I think I leave that to Mr. Yathiraj to have a look at it. This is a new idea I just thought of right now, and I couldn't just stop it because this is how I create businesses around any damn thing from thin air. All right,
awesome.
Over to you, Chief.
Awesome. So I think we need to collaborate, because you create businesses and I make businesses profitable.
Absolutely.
My tagline is my mission actually, is making businesses profitable. That is what my tagline is.
You have put a kind of a good word at this point of time, when everyone is locked down, things are shut, all the shops and businesses are shut down, people are trying to work from home. People who are having an offline business are really needing such kind of people, who can motivate, guide people like you. What would be your advice, when, I don't know about profit, but it is now a question of sustenance. And it's a very serious issue.
Survival, yeah.
Survival,
I'll come to, I will come to that, Amit, in just a minute. But you know, when you were talking about solving problem right now, just today morning, about 11:30, I got a message from one of my mentees. Mm-hmm. She is an MC and she is also a Zumba instructor. Okay. And just 2 days back, we had a talk. And yesterday, she created a program teaching Zumba from her house to people who are at their home. Mm, nice. And yeah. In 1 hour today, she made 17,000 rupees.
Awesome. Nice. I think that's a good inspiration. Yeah.
Yeah. She charged 200 rupees per head and she got 85 people. And she taught them Zumba in an hour and a half. So they, and she had her own exercise done and she made some money.
Yep.
This is what is called. Okay. I mean, I would love to show you her message just now, you know, I mean, where she says, thanks to Yathiji. And, you know, I mean, like, again, it's got nothing to do with Yathiji. It's always got to do with.
But I think, okay. Let's put this, the discussion into this direction, because there's a lot of learning. People are already, informed about a lot of things, but I think if you are not implementing under the right guidance, under the right factorials, and this is an appropriate opportunity to actually making mistakes. What would be your take, Yathiji, on that?
Okay. I believe that if you want to be successful in life, you need luck. Mm-hmm. Okay, but the luck I'm talking about is not the luck people talk about. Mm-hmm. Okay, my definition of luck is L-U-C-K. Mm-hmm. which is an acronym for labor under correct knowledge.
Absolutely nice. So much insightful, profound. Right.
Okay. So what happens is there are, today we have the world full of people who have, there are two kinds of people. There are people who labor, who work very hard. For example, you take these laborers and construction workers. Mm-hmm. They do a lot of hard work, but they don't have the correct knowledge. Mm. On the other hand, we have all these intellectuals. We have all these graduates, postgraduates, PhDs, who have a lot of knowledge, but they don't labor. Mm. So if you don't labor and you have correct knowledge, it's of no use. Mm. And if you labor and if you don't have correct knowledge, you have no use. So my suggestion to everybody will be to use these 21 days to improve your knowledge.
Yeah.
And then, but along with that, spend at least an hour and a half every single day taking some action and planning some action.
Right.
So don't just become a YouTube junkie.
Yeah.
Don't just learn. Yes. If you learn for 3 hours, okay, spend 1.5 hours for doing something with that learning. Okay. For example, just now we are talking on this. So you can create, some kind of a call. You can do something, some activity, and spend at least 1.5 hours planning. Right. I have a program called Network Business Blueprint. In this, I have a formula for success, which I call DGPAR.
I'm sorry?
I have a formula for success, which I call DGPAR.
Okay.
So DGPAR stands for dreams, goals, plans, action, and review.
Right. Nice.
So
profound.
All of us, we have dreams, right? I hardly know anybody who doesn't have dreams. Almost everybody has dreams. But most of the people are not able to fulfill their dreams because they don't convert their dreams into goals. Hmm. So the first step is to have the dream and convert it into a goal. And I'm not going to go into the definition of goal, but I just want to say goal means something specific and with a deadline.
Absolutely.
Now, some people are able to.
Yes, you are absolutely right. We need a deadline to this. Yeah. Go ahead.
Okay. So once again, there are few people who have goals, but they still don't achieve the goals because they don't have a plan.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Okay. So, yeah, just yesterday I was watching a video by one of my e-learning coach. I have a coach. And by the way, this is also a good time for me to tell you about coaching. You know, I mean, like, and I'm 39 for last 24 years. Okay, so nice. You can calculate. All right. And I'm known as India's first sales and profit engineer. I have trained more than 2.5 lakh people all over the world in 11 countries. And nice. In spite of that, I have a coach. Right now, I have a coach. Okay. And my coach is almost like half my age.
Right. Little, so I think that gives you, yeah, that gives you a kind of, you know, an understanding that people who are stuck at home, even though you are the CEOs and CXOs and the top notch, probably the who's and who's not, and the chairperson and the probably the highest level of the designations. But I think it is a great learning from Yathiji also, that you should always have a kind of an open-minded acceptance for learning, for understanding. And what he rightly said is, you know, having trained more than lakhs of students, still coaching and probably having somebody accountable, I think, let's put in the right word, is so very important, so very profound.
Yeah.
Yathiji, I would like to take this. Please go ahead.
Just 1 second. Give me just 1 second. Okay, sure. I'm creating my first e-learning course. First. And he tells me, Yathiji, I have, you know, my coach tells me, you know, I have never seen anybody, you know, beyond 50 who is trying to do something new. I said, but I'm not 50, I'm only 39.
Why 39? Why
not 39 for 24 years?
Yeah, so I was just trying to tease you. Why not 30, why not 29?
There's a reason. Again, you know, we'll go into a diet. You know, there's a
great.
There's a nice. Specific reason why not 29.
Absolutely.
At 29, I had no money to eat.
So I think it's a good analogy.
I was not even getting 3 meals a day. So yes. I don't want to go back to 29.
Okay. But I think, you know, there is something hidden in the past which you should always remember from where you have come in. That is something that I learned from my parents as well.
I never.
You should never forget that. Absolutely right. So let's
never do this. Forget. In fact.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, go ahead.
So let's put this
direction. So we talk about DGPR.
Yes. So let's go to these directions of yours, because you have trained lakhs of people. And now I think India needs such kind of people more. Such kind of Yathiraj, you know, multiplied by infinity is required to put the slow-mo of this world's business to the next, I'll say the Zoom cars now, the next level. So let me ask.
I'm just planning. Yeah, I'm just planning a sales webinar, 3x your sales in 90 days, and I'm planning this webinar in the next couple of days. So sure. Any of your audience will be interested, they can always connect.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Nice. We can definitely, you know, ask the audience to, you know, log in if they want. There are a lot of, you know, as I said, you know, high performance nuggets and high performance formulas are there. Yes, you are talking to somebody who has been into this business. He has been like practicing. He has been training it. I would like to ask you, Yathiji, as I'm sure you have met many people who need some sort of guidance at this point of time. Who needs to, you know, learn from somebody who has actually traveled that path. So what would be your advice to those people who are currently, who are lost about direction, lost with planning. They don't know what to do. The stocks are over and they're in a kind of the situation. I think you can better articulate that. I would like to know what would be your advice apart from the people who are not into job, but into pure 100% business.
Sorry, who are pure into?
Business, 100% into business.
Right, yeah. Okay. See, a little while ago you asked me that no child dreams of going to sales. I don't know whether that was before the interview or
yes.
The interview, but you
might. Right.
Okay. So, you know, that is the time I wanted to say why people don't want to be in sales. See, if I want my son to be a doctor, okay. Or if I want my son to be a doctor, where can he go?
He has to go to some sort of college.
Go to a medical college, right?
Medical college, yeah.
Medical college, and he can become a doctor. Okay, yeah. If somebody wants to become an engineer, where can they go?
Engineering colleges.
Engineering college. If somebody wants to become a lawyer or a chartered accountant?
A bar council or probably, you know, the Chartered University Association of India, you know, whatever
right.
called CSI.
Somebody wants to become a salesperson, where do they go?
Well, I don't know. They have to go to those kind of, but I have never seen an MBA in sales probably directly.
Exactly. You have only MBA in marketing.
Yes, and MBA in marketing is there. MBA in sales is not there. Yeah.
Not there, exactly. And there are not too many people who know that about YA training, which is a sales training issue. So the biggest reason why people don't want to go into sales. See, first of all, sales is a profession where there is too much of rejection, too much of so-called failure.
Correct.
But sales is also the highest paid profession in the world. There
Absolutely.
Is no other profession which can give you as much money as sales. But even if I want to become a salesperson, I don't know how to become a salesperson. So I go out and sell and I'm not able to succeed because there is so much of failure. Because see, even though I'm a great salesperson, I'm happy to close 1 out of 5, 1 out of 3, 1 out of 10. So if I'm not trained, then I'll be closing 1 out of 50, 1 out of 100. And nobody likes failure. And they don't know how to succeed. That is the reason why people don't want to go into sales, Amit.
Absolutely right. And my version of sales, probably I would also say that it is not just only about putting your efforts to just put the products into somebody else's lap, but also you are the front lines. You know, even I see a lot of kids says, I'd never want to get into sales, specifically those people who are into selling insurances, you know, credit cards and loans. They have a kind of a hard time. I can see that. But see on the other side.
Sorry to interrupt you. I mean, they have a hard time because they are not trained.
Absolutely. I'm coming to that point as well. On the other side, you will also find, you know, people telling, boss, I want to see you as an ex-CEO. I want to see you as the chairman. I want to see you as the topmost, you know, the vices and the investors. What do they do? My question to those parents, those mom and dad, who are now directing the kids because you got a chance to probably, you know, that kind of schooling, that kind of environment to become the doctors and engineers. But again, you need to sell the same thing. You need to have that kind of a caliber to sell your art of probably treating patients or treating your clients or treating those kind of people who can take your service. So I think now it is not just about the talent, but about how you implement and position the talent towards serving somebody else. And I absolutely agree with Mr. Yathiraj also. And that brings me to the next question is, now if there is nowhere where you can probably get the right kind of a guidance to get into that level, and if you want to become the CEO, what I feel, and probably I would also ask Mr. Yathiraj to talk on that, is it all starts with understanding and observing. That is my way of looking at things. So if anyone wants to drive into this path, you want to get selected in an interview, you want to get selected probably for some sort of a proposal, a presentation, investment, anything, how do you go? What is the first thing? Over to Chief. How do you want to guide anyone who are listening to this audience?
Okay. The first thing, as you said, understanding, the first thing to understand is everything is selling.
Absolutely perfect. Nice. So nice.
Mother is selling drinking milk to the child. Mother is selling eating vegetables to the child. Everything is selling. You know, even if you're a doctor, you have to sell to your patient why he needs a heart operation. Right. Why he needs a kidney operation.
Correct.
Again, remember, selling means serving people. Selling means solving people's problems. So as a doctor, when you are asking for a kidney operation, you are not doing because you will make money. You are doing because the patient needs it. But if you are unable to convince the patient, okay, you are going to put the patient in danger, isn't it? So Absolutely. If you don't have selling skills, you're going to harm the patient.
Right.
Okay. So, you know, I mean, everything is selling. Even when you're going for an interview, you're trying to sell yourself. You're trying to convince the interviewer why you are the best candidate. You are trying
right.
to sell.
Right.
Only challenge, Amit, is most of the time, the people who are in selling, they focus on their benefit. The key right. to selling is forget about your benefit, focus on the customer's benefit or focus on the other person's benefit.
Right.
Okay, when Modi is talking about, you know, he's talking about the solve, you know, people's problem. Will he be benefited by becoming a chief minister, by becoming a prime minister? Of course. But he's not thinking about his benefit. He's thinking about what can I do to serve?
Yeah.
So any salesperson or anybody, forget about salespeople. The minute you think about, even you're, you know, especially the business owners have to understand this. The business owners have to focus on how can we solve our customers' problems rather than how can we make profit.
Absolutely.
Profit has to be a byproduct.
Sure.
Yeah. Sorry.
Yathiji, I'm so happy that, you know, we don't have much time. We can actually go on, and I think the amount of information is like mind blowing. I think we should do something together. We can bring all these things, and definitely this is a kind of a new level of understanding how human to human interactions, human to human transactions are happening because of this one skill. This one skill that starts first with observing, first with understanding, as rightly, you know, spoken by Mr. Yathiraj also. So with that, probably, you know, as I said, you know, I'm just keeping this discussion so much in a high level of teasing. If you need to join us, probably there should be a link somewhere down below. We'll know a lot of things about the things going to be coming up. There are a lot of avenues going to be opening up. I'll be taking a lot of this interview marathons, and I'll be inviting legends who would be taking India to the next golden bird level also, isn't it? Right?
Yes. And I really want to appreciate the effort you're taking, especially in this time.
Thank you, so much. I'll Thank you so much, Yathiji. It makes a lot of things. Thank you. And before I I'll not say this is not the end, but probably this is the, I have a beautiful way to put this. I rather believe not in closing the deal, but opening relationships. And this is the first time.
Oh my God, beautiful. You just took the words out of my mouth. Beautiful. I always believe the customer must close himself.
I feel there should not be any closing in the business at all. Now, let me put in my version. Because once you close the deal, it's okay. Tata, bye-bye. I've done the things. I've got the money. You've got the product. You've got the solutions done. But when you open relationship, it is all about engagement.
It is the beginning of a relationship.
I think all the businesses, all the big brands are becoming big because of the trust. Trust becomes of, I mean, trust is probably the next version of the first thing that you do is the warm, the comfortness that you provide with your attitude of the business. And I think that makes things a lot of the next version 2.0 of any sort of human to human transaction psychology. So with that, probably let's just to sum up, if you are stuck at home, my, you know, understanding with today's session is you need to look forward an opportunity and a problem. Right now, you have no idea. I have got more than 9 ideas. I have written it down, which are the new possibilities of starting a new business from wherever you are sitting, utilizing just a phone. You want to know how to do that? You can touch me back. My number is there. You are connected with me. I can definitely let you know. Number two. If you need to find a business, you need to find the problem. Number three, if you have found the problem, find the intensity of the problem. Number four, if you have found the problem, you have found the intensity of the problem. And if you don't have anything to solve right now, then find those kind of guys who can help you to at least serve the needy.
Awesome.
Like for example, I am doing it for Mr. Yathiraj now. I might not be a good trainer myself, but I know somebody who has spoken to, touched lives of lakhs of people, not only in India, but I think 11 countries, as you said, sir, right? And now the world is not enough. The world is just probably in the hand of his palm. Right now he's talking and taking the courage to come out of his comfort zone, taking the phone call on his mobile handset and giving his wisdom words. Sir, thank you so much for helping us. It is not just guiding, but it is helping a lot of people. I would love to be more candid and ask you that I am greedy right now to learn so much of good things that you have hidden across from 39 multiplied by 24 years.
So thank you. Thank you.
With that, with my team and probably my entire family, I wish you all the best. I want you to probably live to another 100 years so that definitely, we need a lot of people like you. It is not only Modi can do the wonders, but Modi is such kind of people who are silent warriors and helping India to grow internally. So thank you so much once again for coming here.
Thank you. Thank you very much.